Yeah, we had an emergency this morning.
Is it quite rushy now that we start right away?
I don't mind.
We had a young patient who has acute aortic insufficiency, and we had to take him off on pump to replace the aortic valve. So that was our emergency this morning.
If we replace the valve, we have two options. We can use either a mechanical valve or a bioprosthesis, which consists of animal tissue. Because these heart valves are not living, they do not grow with the patients. They can also not adapt or repair itself. So in these younger patients, such a heart valve needs to be replaced twice or three times or even more times during a lifetime.
Think about that being a young person, you have to take medication till the end of your life. You're always at risk if you go skiing, if you go play soccer, to have a bleeding complication or even a neurological complication due to bleeding. So this is harmful for the patients, and of course we try to improve.
In the IMA valve project, we are developing a heart valve that consists of living materials that can adapt in the human body, it can repair itself, and we also expect that it can grow with the patients. Our heart has four heart valves, and a heart valve controls the blood flow through our heart and through our body. And in the case a heart valve is defect, for instance, it's becoming too stiff to open and close, or it's leaky, you get very tired. The heart has to work very, very hard and your body gets exhausted. And in that case, the valve needs to be replaced. Scientists have been looking to create living heart valves for about 2 decades.
It doesn't exist, and we have created, or at least we are in the process of creating this.
The most fascinating thing is that we create a polymer-based valve that is so smart to attract the right cells in the right moment within the body to transform into a living heart valve.
So we actually make use of the processes in the body that we call wound repair. We start with a material, a polymer. It's a supramolecular polymer that has the right properties to actually communicate with the processes in the human body. And this polymer is produced into a fibrous structure.
A technique that's called electrospinning. The material is formed in a very thin micrometer fiber mesh.
This material is then formed into the shape of a heart valve that we also suture to a stent. And a stent is a manner to deliver the valve at the right size. It can be used to fold the valve in a very small shape. It's beautiful because we can really fold it.
So the system is based on a stented heart valve, which can be introduced via the groin or via a very small incision in the body, and by this we are able to replace heart valves in a very fast and safe manner in many patients. And under live imaging such as fluoroscopy or echo, we are then able in a very controlled manner to deliver those valves to our patients.
You can discuss a lot about this when you will enter the stage of the patient. I think we can enter soon, but it's risky to say this.
So that's not
great. No, but I think 2020 is, we're there.